Thank you, sir. The next session will be welfare sector. This will be presented by social welfare, tribal welfare, BC welfare and EWS, minority welfare and women and children also, along with civil supplies. So I request Mr. Kannababu to take over and cover up on social and tribal welfare. 10 minutes each for each department.
Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon to one and all. Sir, this social welfare department is mandated to take care of socio-economic and educational development of SA community. Apart from giving equal or more attention to the social security and social justice to the community, sir, SC community. This slide briefly talks about insights on the education wing of the department. We got hostels and residentials put together 1240, and we have sanctioned strength of almost 2.35 lakh students, and admission so far happened only in confined to 1.97 lakhs. Still, the gap of some 38,000 is to be done, which is an actionable point to the collector, sir. And then coming to the academic performance, while the residential school performance is better than the state average, but the hostel students' performance is to be improvised to a great extent. Next, please. Here it is. So this slide briefly talks about the different functions or the schemes with which the department will be dealing with. Department deals with the admission, sir, and then the pre and post-matric scholarships, and apart from extending economic support schemes to the SC community. And then this is actually the milestones that were set for the department. And the basing on the directions and guidance given by Honorable CM on 30th of last month while reviewing the department. And for achieving basically what sir has set a target to us is that academic excellence in SD welfare residentials cannot be comparable to the state level, but it should be comparable to the corporate level. That's so the meaning thereby that academic excellence in social welfare residential school should be on par with the corporate schools, and for this we'll be setting up state economic monitoring units, sir, for the purpose of giving continuous guidance and then monitoring the economic performance of the students so that the performance of the students can be taken to the next level. And other important aspect which we are seeing as a gap area in the whole functioning of educational institutions in our department is the rationalization of the existing staff, sir. In fact, we have got more staff in some institutions where they don't really require, and less staff. We are going to go for this rationalization of existing teaching as well as the non-teaching staff for the optimal utilization of the staff. And other important activity which the social welfare department takes up is taking up of infrastructure in the SC habitations, truly tying up the fund support under the SCA subcomponent. This also is the key milestones which I thought we will be doing in the next 1 year. Another important thing on the livelihood front, sir, in fact, this economic support schemes to the SCA community has been given a great go by. And then in the next 1 year, we are going to revive. And for this, actually, how we are going to align with the ongoing Government of India schemes, sir, these are the schemes which we should leverage for really taking care of the milestones that we have set for in the next 1 year, sir. So the first important thing is the PM Ajay scheme, sir. In fact, it is very interesting to note that for the next 3 years, we have got 151 crores sanctioned by the Government of India. And this is for the purpose of income generation activities, up to 50,000 of subsidy or 50% of the unit cost, whichever is less, can be given. Rest can be tied up with Unnati and other such schemes. So district level targets will be communicated very shortly to all the collectors. And other important scheme is Pradhan Mantri Adarsh Grama Yojana, PMAGY, which is 100% Government of India grant. So we have listed out all the villages having more than 40% of the SC population, which are actually qualified to get this kind of support under this scheme. And an amount to the tune of 20 lakhs can be given for gap filling component and dovetailing with other or converging with other schemes, we should really come up with the village development plans for what is our developing in infrastructure in the SC area, sir. And other important proposal, sir, in fact, this is under active consideration. During the review by the Honorable CM on 30th, we made a request, in fact, if we can remit 3.06 crores to the Government of India, then we'll be getting around 206 crores for the purpose of constructing the 62 new hostels and the hostel components of PM Ajay, sir. And these are the interventions that we seek from the district collectors in the social welfare department. So it flows from the actually the milestone that we set in the last for the next one year. So the site selection for the 15 residential schools and then the 62 social welfare hostels for which the fund support under the PM Ajay under active consideration. And other thing is that some minor repairs are to be carried out in all the hostels and then the residential schools for which there are some best practice set up in some of the districts which we request the collectors to replicate by tapping the fund support under district mineral fund or talking to the MPs for accessing the MP land. Earmarked funds also, in fact, will be getting from the Jilla Parishads and Mandal Parishad bodies. And more importantly, the CSR support also you can really tap. In fact, some of the collectors have really set precedence, so those can be replicated. And then more importantly, we have got almost, as I said, 38,000 vacancies are still to be filled. So we request the collectors to really take up the filling of the vacancies. Don't leave it to the welfare functionaries, but ensure that with the approval of the district administration, these vacancies are filled up. Otherwise, there are a lot of complaints which are coming up on the vacancy filling exercise. And then other thing is the post-matric scholarship, because we need to really take up as and when the government finalizes the guidelines for this. So the pendency of the Aadhaar linking and opening of the joint accounts to be cleared in next 2 weeks. And other important activity which is conventionally being done is that we have to regularly, once in 3 months, we have to conduct a district vigilance monitoring committees and then district monitoring committees for review implementation of the prevention of atrocities and protection of civil rights and then the manual scavenging act and all. So that I request the collectors really do meticulously and without fail. And the civil rights day also need to be observed on the last day of every month in the vulnerable SC habitations in all the mandals. And more importantly, for rejuvenating and then activating the SC corporation functioning, we request you to really focus on the recovery of the loan so that we'll be getting continuous loan support from the NSFDC and NSKFDC. And more importantly, as I said in the previous slide, identify all the SC eligible women beneficiaries under PM Ajay. In next 15 days time, we'll be sending a target to you, maybe next 2 days time, and ensure that village development plans are prepared and approved by the district committee for tapping fund under PM AJY. This is what is expected from the collectors in case of the social welfare department functioning. With if the sir permits, we'll move on to the tribal welfare, sir. So these are the important socio-economic indicators pertaining to the tribal areas. In fact, these are very important because this becomes basis for the preparation of plans for filling the gaps that are noticed under various parameters. So on the livelihood front, sir, in fact, in the review also you talked about per capita income of the tribal. Where are they really placed vis-a-vis what is that AP average and then the national average? So the AP average is almost 2.19 lakh per capita per year, sir. And then when it comes to the national, it is 1.72 lakhs. And in the case of tribals, it is 1.37. Especially, in fact, there is no special, way by which tribals income or per capita income is assessed. But we have taken the this ASR districts, sir, which has got more than 90% tribal population. We tried extrapolating that figure for arriving at this per capita income for the tribals, sir. So this long way, I think we need to take up a lot of measures for really bridging the gaps in terms of per capita income between the tribals and then the plain people. And coming to the health indicator, sir, in fact, on the IMR front, 37, and which is to be improved even when compared to the what is at AP level and then national level. And then that MMR is relatively better when compared to the national level, but when compared to the AP, it is to be improvised, sir. And then the birth and death rates also been taken up. And in the last meeting when you reviewed, sir, you talked about replacement levels. And good promising to notice that fertility rate in case of tribals is positive, in the sense that it's more than stable population that we can expect in case of the tribals, sir. So whereas the in case of plains, it is only 1.74. In case of tribal, it stands at 2.1, on par with the national average. So, and then coming to the educational indicator, sir, the gross enrollment ratio in case of the primary is good, but I was told because unlike in the plain areas, the tribal students, especially at the primary level, do not have the Aadhaar. So there is a duplication that is expected in this case. Maybe that is the reason why this GR in case the primary in tribal areas is more compared to the plain areas. And when it comes to the secondary, it is less than the AP and more than the national average. And dropout ratio is also 1.23, sir. And in case of primary and secondary also, it is almost 17 or so, sir. And then going to the next, this thing, these are the key projects are the activities which are taking up in the department. The coffee project is the lifeline of the tribal area, sir. In fact, impacting livelihoods of more than 1.5 lakh families, which have further scope for improvisation, thanks to the efforts of Honorable CM in making Araku coffee as an international brand. But still, a lot can be done on coffee in tribal areas, as a lot of area can be brought under cultivation apart from consolidating existing area. As on date, sir, in fact, we got 2.41 lakh acres under coffee, producing 15,000 tons of coffee. In fact, post to the Honorable CM has given a clarion call to bring 1 lakh more acres under the coffee. In fact, by the end of the last year, we could really achieve that 1 lakh target also. So, but still, 50,000 more acres can be brought under this, sir. I think which will really give, take the income returns of the tribals to the next level, because it's not just coffee when they grow, it is the intercrops like pepper and all adds to their income level. So this is a very promising intervention which we can really take forward in the next few years, sir. Other thing is, under recognition of Forest Act rights, compared to the other states, I think quite a good number of pattas have been given, sir, to the individual forest rights have been given to almost 2.626 lakh individuals covering 4.5 lakh. And then under community forest rights, to 5.26 lakh acres have been given. But the challenge ahead is how to increase the income returns in a sustained manner through comprehensive land development strategies, duly tying up with NRGS and Coffee Board. And other important thing is sickle cell anemia mission, sir. In fact, this is actually genetically genetic blood disorder, which is very rampant in the tribals below 40 years. So this is to be addressed. And in fact, special mission has been constituted at the national level. So this is also a priority area that we need to take up in the years to come, sir. And on the education